Welcome to Georgia Tech Engineering. My name is David, and I'm an undergraduate studying mechanical engineering here. But a few years ago, I was a high school junior in Olympia, Washington, going through the exact same process that you're going through now. I was looking at tons of different engineering programs all across the country. But I'm about to show you what brought me all the way down here to Atlanta, Georgia. But first, I want to introduce you to one of my best friends. Meet Buzz, the number one mascot in the country. Now let's go check out some of the best things about being an engineer here at Tech. Right now we're in the Marcus Nanotechnology Building. It's home to one of the few Class 1 clean rooms in all of the Southeast. It looks like we actually managed to catch the Dean of the College of Engineering here. Let's see what he's up to. Hey Dean May, how's it going?
Hi David, how are you?
I'm doing real well. I'm actually taking a group of prospective students around campus right now.
Great.
To show them some of the unique opportunities that are available for them here on campus.
Outstanding.
Yeah, so what can you tell us about this building?
This is our Institute for Electronics and Nanotechnology, where we're developing some next generation semiconductor devices and integrated circuits.
Wow, that is so cool. And do undergraduates get involved in research like this?
Absolutely. About a third of our undergraduates in the college do research, where it allows them to take what they learn in the classroom and apply it to real world applications for making the world a better place.
Wow, that's awesome. Well, thank you so much, Dean May. We appreciate it. I got to get this group to the next stop, but it's a pleasure seeing you again.
Good to see you too, David.
Here we are at the Invention Studio. This is a makerspace run by Georgia Tech students for Georgia Tech students. Let's go ahead and take a look inside. With tons of 3D printers, mills, lathes, a laser cutter, and even a water jet, students have the opportunity to design and build pretty much anything they want. Hey, Lauren.
Hi, David.
Right now, Tom is working on his next battle bot for his new competition. Let's go ahead and take a look in the 3D printing room. Students can come in here to build models, prototypes, and even stuff just for fun. With 50 3D printers in this room running 24/7, the possibilities are endless. Maybe you're interested in civil engineering. Well, here in the wet lab, students can study how water flow impacts structures, such as dams, bridges, and roads. Students can also work on clean water solutions, earthquake-proofing buildings, and even studying traffic flow. The problems that undergraduates solve in this lab go far beyond Georgia Tech. They help people on a national and a global scale. In fact, more than 50% of engineering students here study or do research abroad. I got to spend 3 months in Australia, Fiji, and New Zealand studying marine biology while still taking my required engineering classes. How cool is that? Let's take a look at what's going on in the cold room today. Hey, Anna.
Hey.
Hey, what are you guys working on in here today?
I'm working on learning how small organisms in oceans, lakes, and rivers respond to different types of water flow.
No way.
Yeah.
That's really cool. Well, I'm gonna let you go ahead and get back to it, and we're gonna take the group and head on to the next lab. This is the robotics lab of Professor Aaron Ames. From household activities to space exploration, robots are going to be a huge component of the next generation. You can get involved from the ground floor in labs just like this one, building and programming the robots of the future. Let's find out more. Dr. Ames, what can you tell us about the work that you're doing here?
So the goal of this lab is to really achieve dynamic behaviors on robotic systems, everything from walking with springs, and running. And we do everything from build these robots from the ground up, do the algorithms running below the surface, and understand the mathematics that really make robots move the way we want them to move. And this goes beyond just walking robots, but extends to humanoid robots, trying to achieve these robots that we imagine we should be able to create with science and technology. And this is just one example of all the robotic activities happening at Georgia Tech. It's a world leader in robotics, and really the goal is to make the robots of science fiction, science fact.
A lot of people don't realize it, but engineering is actually at the forefront of medical research. Georgia Tech students are creating and developing medical products that are being used across the country in state-of-the-art facilities. Dr. Julie Champion is a professor in the School of Chemical and Biomolecular Engineering here at Tech. Her team of students is working on taking protein components out of bacteria and using them to create new, potentially more effective protein drugs. Dr. Champion, what are students working on in this lab?
We're taking a protein out of Salmonella, which normally causes infection in humans,
and we're transforming it into nanoparticles that can be delivered to cells to treat autoimmune disease.
Oh, that is so cool. Well, we've got another stop that we're going to head to, but thank you so much for chatting with us.
Thanks for coming.
A great way to put new technology and materials to the test is to put them on the road and then drive them really, really fast. That's exactly what students do here at GT Motorsports. They design, build, and race formula-style cars as part of the National Automotive Design Competition. And at Georgia Tech, students manufacture about 95% of these parts right here in-house.
Whether it's working on navigation for a Mars rover or designing and building robots for children with disabilities, Dr. Ayanna Howard has done it all. She even has her own TED Talk about making robots smarter. Dr. Howard, how old were you when you knew that you wanted to be an engineer?
I was 12. I was fascinated by anything sci-fi, robots in space. There was one show called The Bionic Woman. I knew I had to build a Bionic Woman. I had to be an engineer.
Wow, that's so young. And I guess now looking back as a professor, what's the best piece of advice that you could give to high school students looking at undergraduate engineering programs right now?
Definitely do research. Find a university that allows you to do creative, hands-on research, especially that of societal value. At Georgia Tech, our students do just that, only at Georgia Tech.
Thank you so much, that's great advice. I hope you guys were taking notes. So what was it like giving a TED Talk?
Terrifying.
Where were you when you did it? So now that you've seen a handful of the labs that we have here on campus, it's time to ask yourself an important question. Do you want to be one of the world's top engineers? If so, just submit your application online and join us and become one hell of an engineer.